Hey guys, this is Jesse from Mullen Woodworks. Today we're going to go over how to build this outdoor bench made out of 2x4s and some 2x2s. It is very simple, easy to follow, free plans. They're in the description, so go check those out. It also gives you the full cut list to know exactly what you're doing. It's an easy walkthrough. Make sure you go check those out. Once all the lumber is cut, it's time to assemble the two bases. At this point, you should have two identical bases, and it's time to start attaching the seat. If you don't already, make sure you go follow me on Instagram and YouTube under Mullen Woodworks. I do plenty of projects, and I have a lot of projects coming up with solo stoves, so check those out. So I started by attaching the two outside rails of the seat to give me the form of the bench, and then I used a liberal amount of exterior wood glue for the inside rails, and they should be really tight joints, and they end up working out really smooth. Now make sure you wipe all the glue off of the joints. Any squeeze out, you will most likely have quite a bit of squeeze out. So make sure you're wiping that all off, and then go ahead and sand the whole bench down. Now it's time to attach the arm supports. So I used a 1/2-inch drill bit to drill out where the buttons will be, so that way no wood screws are shown, and it gives a little bit more character. Now it's time to attach the arms. I used the 1/2-inch drill bit again just for the front two screws. The back two screws will actually be covered up by the back rail support, so you don't need to put the buttons on there. You can just screw those directly in. Now it's time to attach the back support. So I put some wood glue down, and then I did the same process where I drilled out the 1/2-inch bit for the buttons, screwed it down, and then filled in the buttonholes. Now it's time to evenly space out the back rails along the back support. Pretty simple process. I didn't put the wood buttons on the back because you won't see them anyway, but I did put them on the top so that no wood screws were exposed. once the entire bench is constructed, now it's time to stain, seal, or paint the bench. I used a stain sealer combo by Behr. It's actually a deck stain and it goes on better brushed, but I couldn't find a brush, so I used a rag and it actually worked out really, really well. You can also spray it if you have a sprayer, which works probably the best, but it worked out good and I love this sealer. We've used it on multiple projects, including my clubhouse I built for my kids. So make sure you're getting something that's going to hold up to the weather outdoors. Make sure you go download those PDF plans, and we have more builds coming out, so stay tuned.